Good morning. I'm Lieutenant General Todd Semonite, 54th Chief of Engineers, and we're on the road again. Today we're on the road with the great Nashville District, and we're out here at the Kentucky Lock and Dam. This is on the Tennessee River, right near Paducah, Kentucky. With me is Cullen Jones. He's the District Commander. Cullen, we've got about 715 locks and dams in our inventory, and they're all old, and we've got to continue to be rebuilding them. Today, we're right in the middle of reconstructing one of these locks and dams. I want you to tell our core team a little bit, what are we doing here, and describe the project in some relatively straightforward terms.
Well, Chief, thanks a lot for joining us here at our Kentucky Lock Addition Project. You know, you're looking at a $1.25 billion project where we're looking at adding a lock addition. We're talking about an additional 1,200-foot long lock that supplement our current 600-foot. What that's going to do for us is enable movement along the Tennessee River and increase our ability to move commodities. We're talking on an annual basis. We're moving about $5 billion worth of materials through here. One of the key issues that we have is the amount of time it takes for barges to move through the lock. By adding this 1,200-foot lock, it's going to enable a 15 barge tow to move through in no time. That's going to increase the economic capabilities of this facility and also help in a strategic
fashion. For somebody who might not know, the current barges that come down are about 1,200 feet. Because you only have a 600-foot lock, they've got to actually stop, break that barge in half, send it through in two increments, and then put it back together on the other end. So once we're able to get this lock done, it'll be a lot more efficient for the barge industry, which I'd hope at some point would save America some money as well, right?
Correct, sir. You're looking at right now between 4 to 7 hours for a lockage, and now we can actually reduce that to zero.
Okay, so what are some of the things we see here? Just kind of point them out. So what have you already done, and what are you working on?
So on the upstream monoliths, we've already been able to go ahead and do construction and placement of the minor gates. Right now, we're in the process.
So you know, and as you look here, this is the upstream entrance in. It's kind of hard to see through the fence. You'll see some cranes out there, but there's where the gates were already there to be able to open it. You got the left wall, you got the right wall. So you've already kind of finished that end of the lock, right?
Correct, sir.
Okay, go ahead.
And then, sir, looking downstream, we're in the process of installing our downstream cofferdam. Now, we have both conventional cellular cofferdams that you see a lot of construction projects, but we also have an innovative process where we're placing in concrete cofferdam shells.
Talk about the bridges.
So, prior to us executing all this construction, we actually moved a lot of our utilities and our access bridges to allow for traffic to go across. Once we got conditions set in place, that enabled us to start going ahead and conducting the downstream construction.
Yeah, so what you got to know is that a lot of our projects are on relatively tight sites. You couldn't just come in and build this brand new 1,200-foot long lock without moving some stuff. Four great big gigantic towers that we had here that had to be repositioned. There's a substation that TVA had to move. Those brand new bridges. There's a railroad bridge and a road bridge. The bridge is right behind me. Will have to come out because we've got to build a lock exactly underneath me. Now, with me is Barney Shulte. Barney's the technical lead. Barney, the colonel talked a little bit about this innovative technique. Point down here to the rest of the core team and kind of explain what are we doing here and why are we using this technique?
Okay, thank you, General. So what we're doing right now is we're constructing our downstream cofferdam, and that cofferdam will become part of our river wall of our middle wall of our new lock. So it's an innovative technique combining the two. So what you see down here is a concrete shell. This is the first of 10 concrete shells that we will be placing. We use this large gantry barge that you see in the background, the big concrete frame.
Yep.
That barge is specifically designed to pick up each of our shells. There's a lifting frame that attaches to the top of our shells. It picks the shell up off of a casting barge that we constructed the shell on, and then we position that gantry barge in the proper location. We survey it in, and then we drop it in place. We'll come back later, fill this shell with concrete, and continue up to the top of our existing
wall. So to keep
this
very, very, very simple, you're going to build 10 of these great big concrete boxes. You're going to sink them in, glue them down in with concrete basically to the ground. That'll, in essence, build your wall there for the lock, and that'll tie back into the other end. Then you'll pump the water out, take all this material out, and then now you'll have a dry area where you can go back in to build the rest of the lock.
That's
this is amazing technology. What we got to do, Colin, is we got to continue to learn in the core. We can't just use this particular project to be able to figure out how to be able to do this. How do we wrap this into other construction we're doing? But the other big message here is that some of these projects, we just just can't afford as a country to be able to do them all at once. So this one you're having to do with small incremental funding. If there was ever a position that we could get more efficient funding, then we're able to do this in 4 or 5 years instead of maybe 15 or 20 years. And it causes us to be relatively more expensive only because it's run out. So I want to thank you for your team. It's been a great day out here. We just had a big group called the Inland Waterway Users Board who was out here to see the construction. And Barney, your innovative technique, your team, is going to help us down the road. Nashville's doing a great job, and I'm awful glad to be on the road again in Nashville with a great Nashville district. Thanks an awful lot.